Hi guys, Sofok here and welcome to the FIFA 19 player review, and today I'm reviewing the 91 rated Spanish Real Madrid centre-back Sergio Ramos. He did cost me 216,000 coins, and in the 8 games that I played him with, he scored me 1 goal and got me 0 assists, and he does have a 3-star weak foot and 3-star skill moves. Moving along into his in-game stats, his main standout stats were 89 marking, his 93 jumping, his 91 interceptions and his 93 stand tackle. I did have the shadow chemistry style applied to him, which heavily increases both his pace and his defending, and all 8 games were once again the same with Modric played in FUT Champions. To give you guys another quick update on FUT Champions, I was doing well last night, but kind of as Sunday has approached, I've kind of fallen off a little bit. I'm currently on 12 wins and 11 losses. Just need 2 more wins to try and get into Gold 3, which I'd absolutely love, but even so, the rewards for Silver 1 are still very, very good. And focusing now on Sergio Ramos, I think he's absolutely fantastic, and if I didn't need the coins to do other player reviews, I'd be keeping him in my team 100%. I genuinely think I used Godin, and I talked about how good Godin was as a centre-back, and he is still good, but for me, Sergio Ramos is the best centre-back that I've used in FIFA 19. I think he's absolutely phenomenal in so many different areas, just because he's got so many great qualities defensively, even attackively. He's got actually a pretty decent goal for me as well in FUT Champions, but focusing now on his first main pro, it's going to be his pace. I think it is absolutely brilliant, especially with the shadow chemistry style. Now, of course, the shadow chemistry style does cost a couple thousand coins, you know, to buy, but you might have one tradable, you might be able to get one for the objectives, something like that. His pace already at 75 is pretty decent, with 76 acceleration and 75 sprint speed, but with the shadow chem style, he's going to 85 sprint speed, and I believe 87 acceleration, and you can notice that so much in game. He feels so quick, and that's absolutely fantastic. Could not fault his pace whatsoever, backtracking very, very well, being able to catch up to attackers who had got clean through on chances. He was able to catch them up. He's got his good strength as well to be able to, you know, be able to get the ball back. Could not fault his pace whatsoever, absolutely fantastic. His second pro is going to be his heading. Decent height at 6 foot, not the tallest centre back in the world, but it's still a decent height. He's got that 93 jumping, which he absolutely loved. Not many players have got as high as 93 jumping at this stage of FIFA, and also the 92 heading accuracy combined with the 5 plus stats given for the shadow chemistry style goes to 97 heading accuracy. So once again, I could not fault his heading from defensive positions. Unfortunately, from corners, my main attacker threat from that position is being Godin. For some reason, Ramos just never seems to be in the right position there, but anyway, still his heading was very good overall. Next pro is going to be his passing. 78 short passing and 72 long passing, pretty decent. He was very nice at being able to make passes coming out from the back. Obviously, I wasn't expecting anything magnificent or anything like that, but even so, his short passing was very nice, and I couldn't fault his passing whatsoever. And then his final pro, of course, is going to be his tackling. Very consistent at doing so, you know, knowing that. He goes to 97 slide tackle, he goes to 98 stand tackle, 99 marking. Again, you've got team of the year stats with the shadow chemistry style. Most of his defensive stats go to 99, which is absolutely ridiculous. And I don't have any cons to him. The only thing I would say is, you know, you're paying over 200,000 coins, which is a lot for a gold rare centre-back card. However, I think it's money well spent, because I think he's that good of a player. And, you know, like I said, if I didn't need the coins to have to go and do more player reviews, which I like doing, by the way, I enjoy using different players, but if I wasn't doing player reviews, I'd be keeping the Sergio Ramos card. But maybe if I get lucky in my rewards, I might go and buy him back again, because then I'll have more excess coins to be able to go review other players. But at the moment, it's kind of struggling for some more coins at the moment, and I want to keep the likes of Maradona and stuff like that. So I will be selling this Ramos card on, but even so, I would definitely recommend this card to you guys, because I think he's absolutely fantastic. But anyway, guys, that's going to finish off this preview. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you guys later.